Hello together. Welcome to our webinar GLDF, the Global Lighting Data Format, a joint development of the companies Relux and Dialux. I am pleased to introduce you to the CTO of the Relux Informatik AG, Mr. Robert Heinze, who will hold the webinar. If you have any questions, please use the function of the GoToWebinar platform, and we will answer them afterwards. We will record the webinar and make it available for you on our homepage.
Yeah, thanks, Klaus. Welcome to this webinar about our new data format. Yeah, I'm really delighted to hold this presentation here. I waited for 2 years to go to this stage. We have created a new global product data format for the lighting and sensor industry. So we created some kind of digital twin of real products, and together with Dialux, so Relux and Dial together created a new data format, as I said, for luminaires. And in this presentation, I want you to show you why and what we have done and how it works and a little bit of a technical insight of this new data format. Not so deep. We have half an hour for this presentation. It was not really deep, but it's a good start to go into this new data format and to give you some overall information about this format. And of course, we go deeper later on with more seminars and more information. Okay, let's start. The name of the new data format is GLDF. So please keep it in mind, GLDF. It stands for the Global Lighting Data Format. Global means really everywhere. And we did this together with Dial, as I said. This is and you can ask why Dial and Relux doing it together. So why not we doing it out of an association like Z4E, or why we don't do it in CIE or in a standard association, ISO, etc. Because we have a lot of competence together. So Relux and Dial has together almost 50 years of experience in lighting design, lighting calculation, and also in expressing and modeling luminaires in a digital environment. And we put this competence together, really. We have a lot of meetings together with experts from both sides, and we created step-by-step this format in the last 2 years together. With a lot of new features, with a lot of new ideas, and modern infrastructure of this data format and so on. And also the question is why we do it. We have a lot of existing data formats at the moment on the market, which works quite well so far. But there's a large requirement from the industry, also from the designers, to have more information on it. So we have a lot of data formats, but none of them has really the complete area of all information Lumina could contain together. So this was a requirement to have it. And Relux and Dial together has a really big market relevance, at least in Europe, strong in Europe, but also on a global scale. We are quite strong together. And so together we have the chance to implement a new data format to the practice level, to the operational level, and not just in a theoretical way. We're going to practice with this data format, and we wanted to have it in market. And together we will reach this goal much more easy, as just Relux would say, we create a data format. So together there's a stronger force. We have together a strong connection to the industry, but also a strong connection to our users from both applications. This is the reason why we started it together. Let's have a short look into the past, the history of Lumina data formats. We have a lot of good working data formats. So, for example, in Europe, the EULOM.DAT format from Professor Axel Stockmar, which has a tremendous overall wideness in Europe. Every application who deals with luminaires can use it. It's really everywhere, this EULOM.DAT format. And it's just a Wikipedia entry of Axel, and also in Licht, in German conference called Licht conference paper. This is the EULOM.DAT. So it's a really big success of this format. And also in the States and in the North America, we have this IES format, which is really a standard. There is an American standard behind this this IES format, and it's also worldwide in good use, and it's also quite good to express in photometric distribution. And we have a lot of other older formats. There's in CIPSA TM40, so the older ones of you will probably know TM14. My generation, I'm the last one, I know this format. And there's also an old 10 format and a CIE format, which it's similar to IES or in between of IES and AutumnNAT, so also SD-based stuff. And you probably don't know, but it's okay, because these formats are, they're never really in practice. So it's some internal processes you see from time to time in an old sense standard, but not really in practice at lighting design levels. And all these old formats have some problems. There's not enough space in these formats to express more technical data, and there's non-possibility to express commercial information, commercial data. So simple stuff like in price or in G10 tech or the size of the products or the weight of the product. So simply stuff which and designers also need, not just from the lighting distribution point of view, but also from the product point of view. And all those old formats just expresses in photometry, and the photometry is not a lumina. A lumina is much more than just the photometry. A lot of luminas has more than one photometry, for example. And it's not enough just to exchange photometric files in terms of luminas. We need to exchange lumina information, of course, with photometry information on it. So, and here with GLDF, we create a truly lumina data format. And as I said, that the need of more information is growing at the designer's level. So the designer is in need of more information. In need of more and deeper and also in a more variety of information. And also the manufacturers on the other side, they have a lot of more information. There's a lot of information available at manufacturers, because there's also digitalization. You have a lot of digital assets to the luminas, and also manufacturers are happy to share this information. But at the moment, if you look to AutumnNAT or IES, you can just express this photometric distribution, which is the most important part of a lumina. So we are still in lighting design here, but it's not everything. You have a lot of more information you want to express, you want to show as a manufacturer, and also as a lighting designer, you want to have access to all the information. And we just, with this data format, we build the bridge of both sides, of manufacturers, of designers, but not of just of this both parts, of all the parts. We want to have a continuously process in data about luminas from the beginning to the end of the journey of a lumina. And and so we also provide with this data format, with this more kind of information, also best options to make more optimization, better software, better services on it. So this is a need to have a richer data expression about luminas in the market. So what we have done, we created a free and global available data format, which is still maintained. So this is also something special. This data format is free available. This is open for public. The format description, the complete structure of this format is open and available for free. You can use it for free. Everybody is welcome to create GLDF files. There's no license fee, there's nothing. You can just do it. The description is online. You can go for it. But on the other side, we are not creating a public community where everybody can work on this data format and can do what it wants. It's still maintained by Relux and Dialogs, so we take care of this. We will develop it further on, this data format. So we will keep our expertise into the format, and also we're listening to the users and to the manufacturers to improve it time to time. So this is a clear statement of both software houses, that we stick to it, that we want to continue this cooperation, and want to make it to improve to a practice level, that we can really do everything which we have in mind on all the minds which are using this format. And we put in this data format photometric and also radiometric information. We put in, of course, 3D geometry of the luminas, commercial data, as much as you can think about. We put all the the BIM properties out of the ZVOE property list is about 350 standardized properties of Luminous. This is also available in this data format to express, to transport these properties to this format. And we have also an structure in GLDF which allows to have an enriched product variability. We can make a lot of variants of the Luminous and put it together in this in one data format file that we have all the options a Luminous could have. So different extensions, different mounting situations, different geometric options. You can everything put in one file, in one data format, and the user of this format can see what the Luminous can do in practice in real life. So, and this data format, as I said, is really for everybody. It's for every user, for every application, for every design fast. It's not just for lighting designers and for luminaire manufacturers. It's also for facility managers. It's also for wholesalers, for the complete sales process, because everything a luminaire can contain in terms of information is stored in the GLDF. Just everything is included. You can put it through all the design phases till the end of the product line. But you can still see in the end, okay, this is included, this was contained in this luminaire, or the luminaire consists out of whatever. You can see it. This all, everything is stored in this file, even things which are not relevant for lighting design or for lighting calculation. So here, Redux and Dialux really looked in a larger scale, in a larger dimension. We not just care about our applications. We try really to cover the complete BIM-related, digital design-related process of a luminaire life. So really completely. And if something missing, we will add this. We still take care about this format, so you can relax and see, okay, everything is covered in this format. If we have every information in this data format, of course, it will grow, it will be big, and not in every situation. And as I said, this is in format for all the situations. And if you have a situation where you just need a couple or just a small piece of this information, you can still use it. It's just a matter of filtering, of having the right level of the detail. And GLDF file can also just contain, if a manufacturer has no more information, you can just put in an OLMDAT file or an IES XML file or whatever you have as photometric. Just a photometric and the name of the product will work for GLDF. Then you have an validated, proper GLDF file. But of course, with just information of an IES file and nothing more, and just a name. So this is not really attractive for a lot of use cases, but some use cases, it's probably okay just to have this information. So this is mandatory, of course, as the software industry, but also a lot of designers would like to have more information. And then it is up to the designer to enrich the information level, to make more 3D geometry, to put in some spectrums to it or some dim curves or whatever into this file format, and then it's available for a user, for an application, to present it to the user, what the luminaire can do in addition. So this is something, of course, where we should find a level. This is also a process which is not really done in Europe or not in the States, about what is the right LOD, the right loin, the right level of information for which design step. In GLDF, it's just everything possible. You can filter down, you can put everything in it, you can just pass single parts of it if you like. But this is something which we need to do in Europe. It's to find use cases, to express use cases, and to say, okay, in this use case, in easy example is lighting design. In lighting design, you need a lighting distribution, you need the name of the product and luminous lux. Something like this. And this is quite easy to done. But they have all these use cases down to facility management in the end, or mounting or whatever. Then we have a large catalog of use cases, and this is something where we need to know what kind of information is needed. So this is an ongoing process, but it's not finished. But the GLDF is capable to hold every information on it. Sorry. So now we go to the geometry part. The geometry part is for a lot of manufacturers one of the most interesting parts of this new data format. Of course, it's a lot of effort. If you have an Redux and the Dialogs membership as a manufacturer, you have to create two geometry models. So it's not possible to simply convert it. You need really to build two different models. And of course, and manufacturers, I was also an employee at Twilux, a larger manufacturer in Germany, and I had five or six different 3D formats to create for all our 12,000 plus luminas. So this is really helpful if you have just one geometry, or if you at least can shrink down Redux and Dialogs to one 3D model. And this we have here. It's also possible in GLDF to have it. We have one united geometry level for Dialogs and Redux, so for both applications and all other applications, because this is also an open format. And we have not just the possibility to have a united geometry, we have also a lot of more variants of geometry. We have a lot of options. We have three options for geometry in this new format. The first and simple option is just to have non-geometry. If you just have your Eulenberg file, if you just have your IIS XML file, you can put it in the GLDF container, you have a name on it, and then you are ready. Then you have no geometry. The application who pass and read this GLDF file has to decide, okay, I spend a box in cylinder out of what I read in this photometric data file, and that's all. So this is the simplest way to create a GLDF. You are quite fast finished with it by just putting in photometric information. But it's in geometric way, it's none. And maybe there are a lot of use cases where you don't need any geometry. So the complete commercial sales stuff, tendering processes, do not need geometry in most of the cases. So it's also okay to have no geometry in this file. And then we have a second option as a geometry for GLDF. This is parametric. We call it parametric geometry. This is in some kind of bridging the gap between have non-geometry and having a real individually 3D modeled shape of the lumina. In the parametric geometry, I will show the next slide, you have some kind in between. With less effort, you can do a geometry which looks like your lumina with an easy way. We will see it. And of course, the last and the third option with geometry in GLDF is an individually 3D mesh shape which you can 3D design. And here we have created a new format, a new 3D format called L3D. This is the new R3D. So if you're down to Lumina modeling creation for Redux, the new R3D is L3D now. And L3D is also open and public available. So it's not a closed format binary, it's an open format with a free description. You will see it also in the next slide. Let's go to the parametric. This is something really new, something innovative. We have in the parametric geometry, you can describe a lumina based of, at the moment, we have around 50 shapes, basic shapes. So simple models, model shapes, model bodies with some various variables to express different lengths and widths and heights and so on. And here you can, with a table, with single variables, you can create an lumina 3D shape. So here, for in this example, you can enter a length and height and a pendulum height and so on. And this goes to the lumina. And with this expression, with this table, you can create 3D shapes. Sorry. And this brings a lot of a simplicity into a modeling, so you can create 3D shapes out of a PIM system or out of an Excel sheet or something. Of course, you have still to take care about this Excel sheet, about the PIM system values, but it's very easy to change, very easy to adapt, very easy to process in an automatic way. It's with this option, it's possible to create a geometry out of a machine quite easily, more easy than to create a really mesh or surface-based object. And what the output is, it's down to the application. So Redux or Dialogs or any other software can decide I create a volume object of it and surface shape on it and so on. So we have a lot of options, a lot of variability to create different geometrics within simple way. And then, of course, we have the gold standard of geometry, the new L3D format, which we hope this is the new fundamental basic geometry format for lighting industry. Here you can freely, individually create your own mesh-based geometry based on OVJ objects. This is an open, available 3D format in ASCII format. In ASCII format, so quite common, quite open. And we bring together these different OVJ objects in an XML structure. And this open, accessible, free XML structure says, okay, we have here some joints, we have here some luminous areas, we have here the area where the light comes from out, where the LDC is located, and so on. All the lighting information. So this format brings not just geometry, it brings also all the informations we need in lighting, down to electrical connectors, down to mounting points, all the light outputs you can describe in this format, and which is new for Relux, with this format, also for Dialux, is we have here the option to take textures, pictures on the objects, on the surface, with this object, and also surface properties, surface behave of light with this OBJ object. So this is a new possibility to express more information also in geometry. And in a long time in this project, we tried to find an existing 3D format. So for example, we had Collada a long time in our mind to have an existing 3D format which we can easily use and adapt to our needs, that we have the lumina and lighting information into it, but it was not possible in the end. So we had to create a new data format, this L3D, to put in everything which we need on the lumina. It sounds easy, it's not so much, but in detail, we have a lot of information, just the lumina is needed, and which we properly need to communicate between manufacturer and this data format. So we need this new data format. But as I said, this is also open. It's not closed. Everybody can create it. It's not in secret. It's not in binary anymore. Everybody can create it. And we hope that a lot of people will create this format. Yeah, so the geometry brings us a lot of more opportunities as in the past. We have a lot of more options in optimization, which is parametric option. Still, be not afraid if you have no geometry, it's also possible to populate an GLDF data format. And if you have if you could invest in this effort to create a real 3D shape of your lumina, then you can do it in a very good representation. So if you put effort in it, you can also see this effort in this lumina 3D shape representation. And of course, Relux takes care about the conversation. As today, if you provide your lumina information, your 3D option, your 3D models to Relux.net, you get automatically and with no question and Revit family file and also 3DS and DWG. And this will continue with the new data format. So you don't need to take care about these conversions. Relux takes care about this conversion and provides you all the other needed forms of geometry and lumina data formats out of this one really covering it all GLDF data form. Okay, let's have a short look into the structure, just really short, because I could talk hours about this technical structure. GLDF is a zip container. It's a zip container with the extension GLDF. So we put every information we have to the lumina, and there's in the center there's an XML structure. The XML structure we have described in an XSD file, which is available, as I said, for free, available and public. This XML structure contains any single information, any property, any relation, any geometric information, and also all the files. So we have an external file for the metrics, for example. There's no new photometric expression definition in GLDF. We just use the existing ones, so you can put in an autumn dot, an IES file, and also the new IES XML file, which is standard in Italy and also Northern America. You can put it as an asset with a link into this XML structure, and then you have to say, okay, in this and this light emitting areas, this LDC is connected, and these files come all together with pictures, with documents. You can put in your mounting instruction. We have also a separation of pictures in application pictures and product pictures. So we have the choice to put in a lot of pictures to this product. And all these files will be zipped and sealed with the GLDF, and then an application can go into it and take out what's in it. And this container has all the, as I said, the variants in a structure that you can create variants out of the main products in a different ways, and put in several different LDCs to different geometries, to different housing colors, to different other properties. Any property can be different in a variant, and you can put it all together in the structure. So as I said, this is freely available and usable up from last week. So last week was with the Licht event in the German-speaking countries. The big disclosure, a big carpetful of the new data format with the GLDF naming and so on. And since this day, so since last week, there's a website available called gldf.io. And this technical website hosted together from Velux and Dialux. There you have the XSD, some samples later on, and also the geometry definition of L3D together with a lot of technical information which you can use. Okay, it's at the moment we have in quite early stage. So, but it's available, it's public today, and it's theoretically also usable today. And as I said, it's also professionally maintained by both software houses for the next years at least to have it maintained in a professional manner. Of course, we see a big potential to become the next standards for Lumina to contain just everything you want to express, and also future proof, because we will maintain it. Yeah, from our point of view, we have just winners. Everybody is a winner who go down to this new data format. And a designer, electrical lighting designer, doesn't let us get all the information he needs in the right portion he needs. So there's everything included. The industry, the Lumina manufacturers can focus on a single data format. There's no need to create a lot of different formats. You can use this one format, and all others you can just convert out of it. And it's also possible for industry to take this structure, to have this almost complete data structure of Lumina down to your PIM system. So if you don't know how to structure your PIM system, you can also use GLDF. It's available. It's free. Use the structure to express your Luminas for whatever reason. And also software manufacturers like Redux, we are happy to building new fancy services and applications out of this data format, because we have now the option to have in a structured way a lot of more information, and we have tons of ideas to work with it and to create interesting services and applications. So this is for us the reason, the motivation to do this. But of course, the complete industry has a big benefit of it. I also have to say it's free, it's probably available for everybody. But of course, you still need a membership, because this question will come later on. Because okay, this is open, everybody can create an GDF for free. You can use GLDF for free, but the usage inside Velux and also inside Dialux is not for free. You still need membership if you are a manufacturer for Velux and for Dialux in order to see your product in SNG LDF inside our applications. It's the same business model as in the past. So there's no free, everybody can create luminars for both applications. It's still the same, but we have been structured modern data way to bring data in a unified way in our applications and all to all our applications. It's not just limited to Dynamics and Windows. As I said, we have an bigger dimension in mind that also other software vendors can go down to GLDF and create applications around it on this product information of Illumina. Okay, my last slide. This is about the next steps or about the timeline from now. As I said, last week we published this data format, inclusive a lot of technical information and documentary. In summertime, we will publish together with DIAL some libraries in a .NET standard, so some really technical information to pass, to interpret GLDF in a more professional, unified way. This is helpful if you really want to create a GLDF as a manufacturer, or if you want to interpret GLDF as a software vendor. This will happen in summertime. And end of this year, beginning of next year, we will publish a lot of tools. We will publish in the same area like we have today, our member tools. So the member tools, which allows you in a different ways and different methodologies to create GLDF. So for example, a tool to create this 3D modeling, but also, some simple tools to fill an GLDF out of a database, out of an Excel sheet, for example. We have a lot of interesting ideas to make tools around this data format, and we will also publish these tools on this website. And officially, also the usage of GLDF in Redux and in Dynalux happens early next year, hopefully. So this is not on this slide, and it's still some time before you can really put in an GLDF file into Redux and Dialog. So it's not finished now from this interpretation point of view, but we have just published it and we're working it, and I'm sure we will have also for some pioneers, for some tests and examples, Redux ready by mid of this year to see and to work together with some industry partners, this data format in fine-tune, that we can have some better tests with Redux and this new format. So we have not to wait, but officially, if you as an application, as a designer, wants to use Redux with the new GLDF, I have to say, officially by the beginning of next year. Okay. But this is just preliminary, it's not really finished, this roadmap, and we're doing it also together with DIAL. So it's we are in cooperation on this roadmap also. Okay. So this is the end of my presentation. I have to thanks for your patience, and I give over to Klaus for some questions.
Yes, thank you, Robert, for your interesting presentation of the new GDLF data format. And we have actually one question, and So with all this integration potential and extensibility, will this be the last data format in lighting? Question from Niels Hafekemper.
Good question, Niels. It would be great if I could say yes. that we say, okay, we have done this effort once and for all. But I'm not sure. But we will continuously work on GLDF. So If I'm project in the future, I can see an GLDF, which is technically different as today, but it's still an GLDF. So from this point of view, but I'm sure this will consist a lot of years. So maybe the same age as Eulenthal has. And in the difference to Eulenthal, we continuously work on it. So this is also a difference to the past format. You can say, okay, IES is also developing. There's also a couple of years in new standard. But it's still photometric. So this is the first. This is not the last. It's maybe the first Lumina data format which comes not out of one software vendor. Of course, we had in the past Wolf and ULD And there's also a development in this format, but here we have a united and free available format, and there's a lot of potential to be probably to hold it for a couple of decades would be nice.
Okay, and then we have another one. Will the Relux database be modified, extended to contain the new data? And if so, will there be a tool to generate the XML files starting from the Relux database?
Yeah, we will stick to this database for a long time. This will be in transition phase for, I guess, years that we have the older databases. At a certain point, we have to convert the old world to the new world. Today, I cannot say where this conversion starts or where we do it. But of course, we will also have this old format available and usable. But we hope and we try to encourage the manufacturers to go to this new format. Because if you create your old Relux Access database, of course, you can probably in the next month create GEADF files out of it. But you still have the same information level you have in the old way. So this is just a linear transition. You need to put more information in it. And also the structure of GEADF is maybe more easy to fill up as this Access database. So it's also technically a bit more modern than the old structure. But as I said, we stay to this old and going into a transition phase. And hopefully, after a couple of years, we just have this new data format and can phase out the old databases. It would be, for us as a software vendor, quite helpful if we not have to maintain all the old formats, if we can focus on the new ones. But it's also not realistic to say, okay, end of next year or in 2 years, we turn the switch and say, okay, now just GLDF and no Wolf anymore in Linux. I don't think that it will happen because the industry, also in data, is needs some time, and also the manufacturers will need, I guess, at least 1 year in the same time frame as we creating tools and put it into our applications to provide this information properly. This is also in process. This is not so easy to create this. So we also know what the manufacturer has to be aware of it, and we do this way together to this new data era. I try to encourage you to go through this new format.
Okay, the next question is very similar. I guess you have already answered it. Can we convert RAL files into GLDF files?
Yeah, there will be a converter for sure. Is the question is where and if you have access to it, or if you do it just internally and convert it. And also the structures is not so far away. So also Wolf is an XML with assets. It's in transition. It's an extension of the Wolf, if you like to say. But as I said, I would not go for it for the beginning. Of course, you have all the Wolf. You don't want to create everything again. Then you can convert. But if you create a new outputs, if you create a new data output to your PIM system, then I would go for the new format.
Okay, the next question is, you have talked about libraries that will be released is to related is the related API open to allow the development of compatible libraries for different languages?
Yeah, we will provide libraries we have think about C#, maybe C++. Everything out of the .NET framework, so in the Windows environment, we will publish this for free to use these libraries, but we will not provide libraries for any language, for any system. This is just too much, but it's open, so everybody is invited and welcome. So if you know what a library is, and if you're skilled in other languages and other environments, so we would be happy if you could adapt, if you could create a parser, and if you provide this also via this technical website. So we also hope this in a way for the tools would also be nice if a lot of users out there. Of course, you need some IT skills. You need also lighting skills. This is not so often out there. But would be also nice to have some students or some enthusiasts to create also tools around this. This is an open format, so everybody can create and share tools and libraries and interesting applications around this.
Okay, thank you. Can GLDF use data and values from other XML-based Luminar files, and how? As an external linked file or by merging them directly into the GLDF XML structure?
Depends. Of course, you can put external documents as a reference. So you can put, instead of a picture, you can put another an XML structure. But the application who passes GLDF needs to know what it is. So if it's just an XML structure, you get it as a file access beside the picture. So there's no really deep knowledge about this other XML structure. And it would be better and more clear if this XML structure, which contains Luminar information, put in on the right positions on the GLDF structure, the information, then it would be easy to pass and easy to understand for other applications. And of course, you can put in the XML structure, for example, the IES XML structure. This is an external file asset as in photometry. And also the sensor specification, the sensor files are also XML based. So we have, for example, if you put in a sensor to GLDF, it's the new sensor format, SenseXML, which you can put as an external reference, as an external file reference into GLDF and link it with sensor positions on the geometry and so on. So by the way, this GLDF is completely capable of all the sensor stuff for our old Relux sensor format and also for the new XML format of sensors. This is completely compatible and could be used.
And what will be the benefits for the manufacturers that are in membership with Relux and Dialux compared with third parties? If the GLDF is open, that there are differences from the membership and third parties?
No, there's no difference. It's the same way as if you put in Wolf or in ULD file. It's the same business mechanic. You have to have a license. You have to have a membership in order to be present in Relux and also in Dialux. It's the same story. With GLDF, you have just to create technically one data format. You have not to create two, so one for Relux, one for Dialux. You can create one, and both applications can understand it in the same way. But you need to have a license key in this file for application. So you can make a GLDF file, which is allowed to go into Relux with a Relux license key, and the other way with Dialux, or both, if you have both. And the first benefit is for manufacturers who have a membership for both applications. So you have to create both old file formats, and now you can just create one file format. So this saves a lot of effort, especially on geometry, as I said, that you just need to model one geometry and not two geometries for both applications. And if you are a third party manufacturer, so if you create an own GLDF file, which is possible, so the document, the technical documentation, the XSD file, etc., is available for free. Everybody can create a GLDF file right now. And if you put this GLDF file into Relux, so assuming that Relux can understand it, so we have to wait a couple of months. Then it's down to the application. What happens? So at Relux, for example, you would go into this third-party procedure that you don't see the Luminar name, for example. And you can calculate, but nothing, no proper output and so on. This is open to application. So the real full service you just get with the membership. And there are also options in between, which you can think about. This is also more freedom for software providers, that you can say, okay, here we have this key, this is this manufacturer, I apply this or that, full access, half access, whatever. So more options for everybody.
Okay, and one more. Will GLDF data be exportable through Relux, in example, energy, luminaire schedules, etc.?
Yes, yeah, quite simple. We will put GLDF in every single application we have. Also, for example, in the new Relux Analyze application, which comes out soon, it will also be compatible with GLDF. As I said, it should be industry-wide in every application as the new Lumina standard.
Okay, and there is a mic from Markus Hege. I will just read it. GLDF is the unique opportunity to make the luminaire and sensor industry independent of other product formats. If someone wants a different format, they can use the GLDF. Everything is there, but they can do the work themselves. Okay. This was just a statement from our CEO. Okay, if nobody more has a question, so I will thank you for your attention. And we from Relux Informatica AG will wish you happy Easter and stay healthy and hope you seeing you soon in real life. Bye.
Bye-bye. Thank you.